back to normal. So all that crazy crap yesterday really was a dream after all. Wait, that's the door from yesterday.
Those are the embers of the delusion. In time, that door too will disappear from reality.
Saki?
And don't forget about me! I'm here too!
Okay, so you're here. But why?
Pinkun, be careful. It's not safe to show yourself right now, remember?
Yeah.
Well, that settles it. I must still be dreaming somehow. A dream within a dream. Anybody got a top?
Yesterday, we nullified the encroachment of a delusion, and then found ourselves repeating Sunday all over again. But this isn't a dream, nor is it a delusion. This is reality.
I was afraid you'd say that.
Pinkun and I have been pretty busy since we parted ways with you, Asahi. We've been following a few leads. We've managed to confirm that this is, in fact, Sunday. The same Sunday as yesterday, all over again.
The same Sunday?
Your friend, Mizuki, was it? The email you received from him is proof positive.
Yeah, it was the exact same one he sent me yesterday, down to the letter.
Furthermore, it seems as though no one in all the city, ourselves excluded, can recall anything that happened yesterday.
So, are you saying that the three of us traveled back in time or something?
I don't know if that's quite it either. I believe that whatever happened didn't happen to us, but rather to the world. It's the world that's not right.
Okay, so the world repeated Sunday, but left us literally out of the loop?
Not just us. There are other elements that didn't make it into this loop, as you put it. Just take a look at Akihabara Station. Door aside, there isn't a trace of the delusory consumption to be seen.
Great! But what does that mean?
The consuming effects of the delusions and those of us who perceive them are not subject to this repeating loop. Which suggests the repetition of this Sunday and the delusions are connected. It's the only logical conclusion.
So you're telling me everything not connected to the delusion is repeating?
Yes. TV and radio programming is identical. And I've no doubt once midnight passes, it'll be Sunday yet again.
So that cat ear cafe I keep passing is forever doomed to live through its grand opening over and over again. No, and Mizuki, will he be forced to wait for me to show up at Fosmap for all eternity?
Yep, and you'll be a neat forever too.
Pinkun, could you at least pretend to try and behave? But doesn't that sound boring, Asahi? The same day repeated over and over again without any changes?
I think the word boring is too exciting for that kind of hell.
I couldn't agree more, which is why I want you to stick with me from now on.
Huh?
I was thinking it over after you went home, Asahi. How nice would it be to have someone like you by my side?
Wait, what? I don't know if we're ready for... what do you mean by that exactly?
Well, I've been kind of uneasy since I came to Tokyo. I don't really have anyone to call on for moral support.
I don't think my heart can take this. It's all so sudden.
I want you, Asahi. I want your help nullifying any and all encroaching delusions.
Aha. That makes more sense. Probably should have figured.
For the two of us to meet at random like this. For both of us to be able to perceive these delusions. It has to be fate, doesn't it?
Besides, Nido Mosquito, you ain't got any other plans. You might as well.
Ah, damn it. You try to help one person once and pay the price forever. I should have known better. How am I even supposed to help you guys anyway? Like, what am I supposed to do?
How many times must we go over this? Help us nullify any delusion attempting to encroach on reality in Akihabara.
In Akiba? Why just Akiba?
Because delusions are drawn to Akiba more often than anywhere else. It's practically an epidemic.
Really? Maybe I just couldn't see them before.
That must be. But right now, we've got more than just delusions to worry about. We've got a repeating timeline, too. Though, I have a hunch that if we take care of every encroaching delusion, this problem should resolve itself shortly.
Yeah, I'll pass. The whole monster fighting thing isn't really my jam.
Leaving a poor girl all alone in a dangerous town like this is your jam, then? I see your cruelty knows no bounds.
Actually, Akiba's pretty safe. Crazy otaku crime has been blown way out of proportion by the mainstream media.
I see. Well, when I meet my violent death, I will look to the skies and lament that you weren't there to help. I suppose I'm destined to fight against the invading Delusion hordes with no one but Pinkun by my side. Adrift on these lonely streets until eventually, inevitably, a strange man earns my trust and lures me his way.
Yo, I think you've got enough delusion to go around yourself right there.
Poor Saki. To think Asahi abandoned you, even though, as a dirty neat, he has absolutely nothing better to do.
No, Pinkun. It's all right. But thank you for being my rock in this, my time of greatest need. I must simply take solace in the fact that I am the Chosen One, destined to save the world from a delusory fate. Even when I'm unsure or alone, or approached by a strange man with an alluring offer, I will not be daunted. Even in this town where I know no one but Asahi, and can count on no one but Asahi, I shall persevere without him.
I mean...
You always have me, Saki. I'll do my best to help you in any way I can. So please, let me see that smile of yours. Pinkun! Saki!
Okay, now just hold up. There's no need to pretend to cry. People are staring. Just stop, please. Damn it! Fine, you win, okay?
Does that mean you'll help?
I will, but only because I know a lot of people in Akiba and don't want any weird rumors getting started about me.
Thank you, Asahi. I'll be counting on you.
You're a credit to neats everywhere.
Yeah, and you're both con artists.
Well, what do you say we get started? First off, let's investigate Main Street.
And they're off. Honestly, this isn't all that bad, I guess. Things were starting to get kind of boring anyway. Plus, I'd hate to force Mizuki to wait for me day in and day out.